Good morning, students. The topic for my today's presentation is human gene therapy. This is fourth unit topic under applications of biotechnology in medicine. So what is gene therapy? Gene means a segment of DNA that encode for a particular character in our body. For example, the color of our hair, the color of eyes, the height, even the intelligence of a person is controlled by the gene in our DNA. DNA is the genetic material. So, to do some therapy means to cure from disease or to give some medicine in the form of gene is known as the gene therapy. So gene therapy is the introduction of genes into existing cell to prevent or cure wide range of disease. It is a technique, that is biotechnological technique, for correcting defective genes responsible for disease development. And the first genetic disease was cured on September 14, 1919, US, when Ashanti De Silva was treated for ADASCID, that is replacing a mutated gene with a healthy copy of genes. What is SCID? This is severe combined immunodeficiency disease. So this girl is Ashanti De Silva. She was suffering from SCID, and that disease was cured with the help of a gene on September 14, 1919. In our body, cells are of two types, somatic cells and germ cells. What are germ cells? Germ cells are cells that are able to produce and reproduce. They produce gametes in living organisms through sexual reproduction. And somatic cells, on the other hand, is not a gamete cell. It is also found in multicellular organisms. So other cells which are present in the body than the germ cells are known as the somatic cells. They are found in blood, connective tissues, bones, skin, and the internal organs. On the basis of type of cell, the gene therapy is of two types, that is somatic cell gene therapy and germline gene therapy. In somatic cell gene therapy, therapeutic genes transferred into the somatic cells. That means the body cells other than the germ cells. And in germ cells or germline gene therapy, gene will be transferred into the germ cells. For example, in somatic cell, introduction of gene into the bone marrow, blood cells, skin cells. And in case of germ cells, that is gene introduced into egg and sperm, because egg and sperm are the germ cells. So in case of somatic cell gene therapy, it will not be inherited in the later generations, because the gene will be there in the body of the patient, but it will not be inherited to the other generations. But because in germline, the gene is present in the sperm and egg, so it can be inherited and passed on to the later generations. In somatic gene therapy, all research directed to correct genetic disorders in the somatic cells. But in case of germline gene therapy, ethical and technical reasons are there, so it is not been attempted at present. Somatic cell gene therapy is further of two types, that is in vivo gene therapy and ex vivo gene therapy. What is the meaning of in vivo? We use this word in when that means in the living organisms. In vivo means in the living organisms. For example, an experiment that is done in vivo is done in the body of a living organism. And what is ex vivo? Ex vivo, for example, some work is done on a part of that organism, that is on the tissue or cell, but in the lab. So that is known the ex vivo, and in vivo gene therapy, direct delivery of gene into the cell of a particular tissue in the body, that is in vivo gene therapy. And ex vivo is transfer of gene to cultured cells and then reinsertion. What are cultured cell? Cultured cell means we take a cell from a body, then we take that cell in the lab, and we under lab conditions that is similar to our body conditions, we try to multiply that cell, and that is known as the culturing of cell. And we will transfer that gene into a cell, then we will culture that cell, and after that we will reinsert into a living body or a person or a patient who is suffering from some disease. So ex vivo gene therapy, it is the first gene therapy to correct deficiency of enzyme. Which enzyme? The name of that enzyme is adenosine deaminase, ADA. And the deficiency of this enzyme caused the loss of immunity in the body. And it was performed on a 4-year-old girl, Ashanti De Silva, who was suffering from a disease. The name of that disease was the SCID. SCID is the severe combined immunodeficiency disease. Because of this disease, this girl was prone to a lot many diseases because her immunity system was not strong. So cause due to defect, this disease was basically because of there was some defect in the gene coding for this enzyme. So deoxyadenosine accumulate and destroy T lymphocytes. So this deoxyadenosine accumulate and destroy T lymphocytes. T lymphocytes basically provide the immunity to the body. So it disrupts the immunity and suffer from infectious diseases and die at young age. So in this slide, you can see the ex vivo therapy to cure the disease of SCID in Ashanti Silva. The disease of SCID is due to the deficiency of ADA. ADA is adenosine deaminase enzyme, and this enzyme is encoded by a gene. The name of gene is the ADA gene. So this ADA gene is defective in Ashanti De Silva. So this gene should be replaced by a normal gene. So from where this gene will be taken? This gene was taken from a bacteria, and that was transferred to the genetically disabled retrovirus. Genetically disabled retrovirus is a virus. What virus do? They carry the genetic material. They are vehicle. So they are disabled means their virulence factor is the factor. Virulence factor, the factor that caused the disease in the person, have been destroyed. So this virus is carrying the gene, that ADA gene, that is defective in the girl, and we want to replace that gene. We take from the bacterium, put in the virus, and then this is known as the cloned ADA gene, is incorporated into a virus. Then it is incorporated to a virus, and that retrovirus infect the T cells. From where we will take the T cells? T cells we with disabled ADA gene we will isolate from the SCID patient. And in that we will introduce the retrovirus infected T cells and transfer ADA gene to the cell. And what will happen? Then we will culture the cells in the lab. Culture the cell in the lab means we will multiply the cells in the lab and we'll check that ADA gene is active. That is, it is working properly. It is secreting the enzyme adenosine deaminase. Now, this cells, that is T cell with normal ADA gene, is genetically altered cells are re-implanted to produce the ADA. So this is re-implanted into a fetus baby or into a patient so that they can cure from this disease that is known as the SCID disease. Now, in vivo gene therapy. So, in vivo gene therapy, that is the direct delivery or direct therapy. Direct delivery of therapeutic genes into target cells into the patient body, like we will give the injection to a patient, we will transfer the genes in the injection to the patient, that is known as the in vivo gene therapy. It is carried out by viral or non-viral vector systems. It can be the only possible option in patients where individual cells cannot be cultured in vitro in sufficient numbers. For example, there are some cells, they cannot be multiplied in the lab easily. In vitro means in the lab. So in that cases, we have to take help of in vivo gene therapy. That means we have to take the genes and then directly inject into the body of the patient. So in vivo gene transfer is necessary when cultured cells cannot be re-implanted in patients effectively. So the last step is when you culture the cell in the lab, that is to multiply the cells in the lab with the normal gene. But to re-implant in the patient is not that easy. So if the body is not accepting the implant, so we have to give this in vivo gene therapy. So students, in this lecture we have covered the what is gene therapy and what and the types of the gene therapy. For further query, please contact me at purarani@yahoo.co.in.